It's an astronomical honor to visit with John Gianforte.
All right, so this is entering in the original UNH Observatory.
Director of the UNH Observatory. He travels to eclipses and is ready for this one.
Is it the wrong part of the sky? We can always rotate the dome. When eclipses happen or meteor showers happen or, you know, comets come by, we're all excited about those kind of things.
Yeah.
And then the light comes in from one end.
John helps students conduct research projects and observe the sky, New Hampshire providing one of the best vantage points for the eclipse.
The moon has two shadows, a dark inner shadow called the umbra, and then the outer, lighter shadow called the penumbra.
The umbra shadow passes across the Earth's surface rapidly.
Part of that path of totality, the inner shadow of the moon that causes a total solar eclipse, cuts the northern, extreme northern notch of New Hampshire and Vermont and upstate New York.
He cherishes those few minutes of totality.
The moon is completely blocking the sun, except for its outer atmosphere called the corona, explosions of superheated plasma called prominences that are leaping off the sun's surface, especially when it's active, like it is in 2024.
So this is the little observatory.
This is the new dome.
The new dome.
Yes.
Okay.
This is our newest telescope.
When not in totality, he says solar glasses are a must.
It doesn't emit just visible light radiation. It emits ultraviolet and infrared. And that's what damages your eye. So it looked like a sideways smile. That's what it looked like. It looked like a smile. To me, it's science, but in the midst of the eclipse, it's one of the most emotional, thought-provoking, beautiful natural events that you can see in the sky.
In Durham, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.